What's up, everyone? This is Nick at Stridewise.com, and today I am reviewing my very first pair of boots, the 8890 Mock Toe Boots from Red Wing. So Red Wing was founded by Charles Beckham in 1905, and they are definitely one of the best known names in the world of men's fashion, at least when it comes to boots. When they started out, they mostly made knee-high boots for like oil workers and iron miners and things like that. And while today they still have a very wide variety of work boots, they might be best known for their very fashion-focused Red Wing heritage line, the most popular boot of which is definitely the Iron Ranger. But today we are taking a little stroll down memory lane with these 8890 Mock Toe boots, which are also very, very popular. And these were my very first pair of boots. They're about 3 years old. So how do they hold up? Let's take a closer look. Now the Mock Toe is a very beloved variety of Red Wing's boots. There are a lot of photos out there of Drake and Ryan Gosling wearing the 875 Mock Toe, which is a lighter brown color, which might be a little bit more popular. But for me, I wanted something that went with my wardrobe, which is mostly blue or gray clothing, and this works really, really well. And they are a genuine Mock Toe. It's not a fake Mock Toe like you'll get on some brands like the Alden Indie. But they are very informal shoes. You don't want to wear these with a suit. I even honestly feel a little bit weird wearing them with like khakis and a button down, unless it's like a flannel button down or at least something plaid, because they're pretty informal boots. But the upshot is that these are boots that you can comfortably wear with like a t-shirt or a Henley or anything from Levi's, basically, especially with this white sole here, which is made from crepe. It lends it an almost sneaker-like appearance, which I really, really like. And then the leather is also really unusual. So this is called rough and tough leather. First up, that's a full grain leather. So that comes from the top layer of the hide of the animal. Most people like full grain for their boots. It's understood to age better and to mold around your foot better. After 3 years of wearing these, I can attest that it has molded very nicely around the shape of my foot, although it is a little tough to break in, which I'll mention in the next section. It's also oil tanned, which is important to remember when taking care of them. Red Wing has their own tannery, actually. It's called the SB Foot Tanning Co. Rough and tough is a kind of pull-up leather, so it's extra moist. It's saturated with more oils and waxes and other leathers from Red Wing. And there's an argument to be made that this makes it more durable and easy to take care of. And I mean, like, yeah, it doesn't look quite as Old West cowboy as some of Red Wing's other leathers, like Amber Harness. But in my opinion, it makes up for that with the durability. I've worn these in 3 horrible New York winters and a lot of thunderstorms. And I think they just look really good after everything I've put them through. Plus, the care regime is really simple. Now, regardless of whether or not rough and tough actually is tougher, there is a consensus that it doesn't need conditioning quite as often as your normal full grain leathers. Once or twice a year, depending on how often you wear them and what kind of punishment you put them through, should be enough for these kind of boots because the leather is so moist. And unlike a lot of Red Wing's boots, you aren't recommended to use mink oil with this. Instead, they suggest the all natural leather conditioner, which is over 90% mink oil. But you know, it also contains lanolin and beeswax, so it might do a better job of waterproofing or at least increasing the water resistance. But you don't have to use that if you don't want to. With oil tan leather, there really is a really wide variety of products you can use. You can use Red Wing's leather cream. You can use Venetian shoe cream if you want. And both of those should do a good job at preserving the original color of the leather. That often isn't a really big priority for like these gray and black leathers as it is for like the nice rich brown leathers. But yeah, nonetheless, if you're really, really attached to the color when you get them, you can use like more of a cream kind of a conditioner, and that should do a better job of preserving that color. For me personally, I've been using Obernaus leather oil on this, and I also use that on my Red Wing Iron Rangers. I probably shouldn't have for those boots just because it darkened the leather quite a lot. But on this one, on the charcoal rough and tough leather, it really was fine. I mean, I've been using that oil on these quite a few times, and this is pretty similar to the color that I got them in originally, and I'm very happy with the way that it has preserved this leather. In any case, this is an oil tan leather. There are many different ways you can condition them. You don't have to get really married to one particular brand or product. So I was very surprised when I learned that the sole here is made of crepe. It's a crepe sole rubber. That's also called plantation rubber. It's a crude, cheap form of natural rubber made from running coagulated latex through heavy rolls and letting it dry. It comes from tapping rubber trees and has a real reputation for being comfortable, but not all that durable. It's probably best known for being used in the sole of the Clarks Desert boot, which is a very fragile sole, as you can see. This sole isn't that fragile, though the guy at Red Wing told me that it's a lot more densely packed than what you'll find in the super cheap crepe-soled shoes like the Desert Boot. Again, I've had these for 3 or 4 years, and while clearly I have a problem dragging my heel a bit, the sole has never at any point felt like remotely like the very cheap Clarks Desert boots, which really takes in water very easily in wet conditions. I haven't had that experience with these. These do work just fine in inclement weather, in my opinion. The sole is very comfy. It is more porous than like cork or leather, but yeah, I've never really had issues with it. This lug pattern here keeps from picking up too much mud, although obviously it's easy to run down. As you can see, I've kind of mangled the grip there a little bit. There's also a cork midsole and a leather insole on the inside. There's a little bit of leather lining around the vamp here, around the toe, but the rest of the boot is unlined. And there's no shank. Red Wing doesn't put shanks in any of their wedge-soled boots, so you may find that sacrifices a little bit of the stability you might be used to, especially if you've been wearing the Iron Rangers. And then finally, it's a Goodyear welt. There's a Goodyear welt all the way around here. It's a full 360-degree Goodyear welt, unlike the Iron Ranger, which is like 270 degrees. That's just a method of attaching the upper to the sole. Goodyear welts have like an extra layer of rubber or leather between the two, the upper and the sole, which makes it a bit more water resistant and a lot easier to resole, which I should probably start thinking about doing. So right now, this boot is available in sizes 7 through 13 in D and E widths, although in my experience, they don't restock the E very often, so sometimes you're just gonna be able to use a D width. That wasn't an issue for me since I am a D width, but for people with wider or narrower feet, that might be a bit of a bummer, like that's a pretty big downside to this brand. But anyway, I'm a D width, and for the actual size of my foot, I'm an 11 in Red Wing. I'm between an 11.5 and a 12 on a Brannock device, but I'm an 11 in Red Wing. So they definitely don't run true to size. You want to order a good half size down. Some people feel they need to order a full size down. So that is something you're going to want to keep in mind. When you're breaking them in, it's not very fun. I definitely got some blisters the first week or two I was wearing these. That's pretty normal with Red Wing shoes. They use very thick, very tough leather, so you do have to spend a bit of time breaking them in. You want to alternate days of wearing them on and off. But yeah, after that week or two, everything feels pretty fine, and they are very comfortable shoes. The crepe sole is not as sturdy as like a leather or a Vibram sole out there, and when you're walking around, especially on, say, cobblestones or something like that, you can kind of feel the gaps in the pavement itself because it's a crepe sole. You can feel a lot of that stuff coming through. But the upshot of that is that it is very, very comfortable. The sole is very, very soft, and the mixture of crepe and the cork midsole and the leather insole, they do all mold to the shape of your foot. So even though there's no shank in this, so you don't technically have as much arch support as you would in like an Iron Ranger, nonetheless, after the 3 years I've been wearing these, it's basically like I have a pair of shoes that are designed for my foot. So the comfort is really great with these. So if you're tossing up between these and the Iron Rangers, the cost is definitely a bonus with the mock toes. A pair of these boots is just $270. The Iron Rangers are like $320 at the very least. I think it's best to get these on Amazon. On Amazon, I've seen the black versions of these boots drop to $250. And while the price does fluctuate a little bit on Amazon, in my opinion, they're pretty much always cheaper there when you compare it to Zappos or Nordstrom. That said, Nordstrom does often put these on sale. So if you are patient, if you're willing to hang around for a while, you might be able to get them at a cheaper buy on Nordstrom. All right, so why should you get a pair of 8890 mock toes? I mean, they are really nice and informal, which I think is a really big pro. A lot of boots, even the Iron Rangers from Red Wing, I feel kind of weird wearing them with a t-shirt or a Henley. That's just a personal preference. But these boots, they are nice and informal boots, especially with the kind of sneaker-like sole here and the mock toe, of course. They go great with Levi's or anything like that. Big fan of that. The price is also really good. These are very inexpensive boots. It's true that there are some mock toes from like Thorogood and Chippewa that are about $100 less expensive, but in my opinion, I don't think they have anywhere near as much quality as Red Wing brand does. So I think if you're gonna get mock toes, I think it's a really good option for the cost in relation to the quality. I really wanna point that out. The leather aged really well. This is specific to the charcoal rough and tough leather. They've also got rough and tough in another more brown color, which I really like it. I didn't really like the sound of it when I first heard of it, and it's true when you look at it, it doesn't look quite as full grainy and cowboy-y as a lot of other leathers out there, but they need very little care. You don't need to condition them very often. It's very nice, moist leather, and they aged really well, which is a big bonus of these boots. I never even used shoe trees with these, which might have outed me as a bit of an amateur when it comes to boots. I only really kind of learned about shoe trees later on in my boot journey, but these I just kind of left them lying around and they just look fantastic. I mean, they aged really well. There's a little bit of creasing here, but like I definitely nothing that I can't stand. And all in all, I've had these for 3 years and they've just done a great job of withstanding the punishment I put them through. So, I mean, there are a few potential downsides to this boot. Number one, it is informal. I mean, that's a pro, but it can also be a con. Doesn't go well with suits, doesn't go well with slacks. They're really just like chunky, mess around, durable kind of boots. That's what they're made for. They're not made to seamlessly integrate from the bar to the workplace to like a black tie dinner or anything like that. That's definitely worth pointing out. It's not lined. I mean, it's not fully lined. There's a bit of lining down by the vamp, but not around the back here. So I gotta say, it's like a workhorsey kind of boot. Again, it's not the most luxurious sensation walking around in these. It's also worth mentioning. The crepe sole, I quite like it. It's very soft, it's very comfortable. It is not as stable as something like a leather sole or a Vibram sole. It doesn't have quite as much grip. It falls apart a bit more easily. It grinds down a bit more easily. And it's more prone to sort of like breaking apart under like certain conditions. Then again, I've had these for 3 years. While I obviously do need to resole these, I've been pretty happy with its performance, but like you don't want to go hiking in these or anything like that. It's a very flat sole and that does have some downsides. Okay, so those are my thoughts on my very first pair of boots, the charcoal rough and tough mock toe boots from Red Wing. For the very long and lovingly written review, just click the link in the description below and make sure you subscribe. I've got a ton more boot reviews coming up.